A person who is accused to have committed an offence is tried in a criminal court. The court, before declaring the person guilty of the offence, gives him an opportunity so that he can establish the absence of intention or evil mind from his part. In other words, the court gives the accused an opportunity to establish the absence of mens rea from his part. For that purpose, the accused can establish certain defenses to get exemption from criminal liability. Such provisions, which are available to any accused in order to go unpunished, are called general defenses or general exceptions. Mistake is one such general defense establishing which an accused can go unpunished. Therefore, even if injury or damages is caused to any individual, the law will not punish the wrongdoer if the person has committed the act by mistake. Why it is so? For this, we need to understand what is mistake and also the two kinds of mistake. The first one is mistake of fact and the second one is mistake of law. Mistake literally means commission or omission of an act either ignorantly or unintentionally, thereby causing injury or damages to others. What is mistake of fact? As the name suggests, it is an erroneous act with regard to the mistake in the understanding of a fact. If mistake of fact is so, what is mistake of law means? The term law that comes in mistake of law refers to the general law of the land. By this, it includes all the bylaws and the rules and regulations that has the force of law. So, under the concept of mistake of law, everybody is presumed to know the law of the land. Therefore, when a person comes forward and says that he is unaware about any law of the land, or he is unaware about any particular act or rules, then we can say that he has committed the mistake of law. Fine. Why we should understand the difference between mistake of fact and mistake of law? We should understand the difference because mistake of fact is a good defense to get exempted from the criminal liability. But mistake of law is not. Therefore, always remember that mistake of fact is a good general defense while mistake of law cannot be submitted as a defense. Let us consider two relevant case laws in order to understand better the concept of mistake of fact and mistake of law. The first case law is about Mr. and Mrs. Tarlson. In this case, Mrs. Tarlson married Mr. Tarlson. But soon after the marriage, her husband deserted her. So, Mrs. Tarlson searched for the whereabouts about her husband for more than 7 years. Mrs. Tarlson made all the inquiries about her husband and learned from reliable sources that he died in a shipwreck. As a consequence, Mrs. Tarlson got remarried. But unfortunately, sometime after her second marriage, her first husband, that is Mr. Tarlson, reappeared and charged her for the offense of bigamy. So, in this case, the act of Mrs. Tarlson in getting remarried under the belief of her husband's death is nothing but a mistake of fact. The court accepted this as a good defense and she was held not guilty for bigamy and was acquitted. Let us consider the second case, which is known as Weed's case. In this case, the accused was an illiterate. He was informed in good faith that he had been granted divorce from her first wife. Believing so, he got remarried. But unfortunately, his first wife charged him for bigamy. It is to be noted that the court held him guilty of bigamy and convicted him on the ground that ignorance of law is no excuse. We have to understand that Tarlson's case and Weed's case are quite distinct from each other. In the former, there was a mistake of fact which is excusable and hence Mrs. Tarlson was acquitted. While in the latest case, there was a mistake of law which is not excusable and hence the accused was convicted. Therefore, we can understand that mistake of fact is a good defense while mistake of law is no defense at all to get exempted from criminal liability. Thanks a lot. We'll meet you again.